Hi, and in today's tutorial I'm going to show you how to create this cover page in Word. So the first thing we're going to do is add some graphics. So if we go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and just go down to this triangle here. Then all you need to do is click and drag out a triangle. Now if I just click and drag, you can see the triangle will distort. If I hit my Shift key, then it will keep it in perfect ratio. So I'm just going to drag out that triangle and now I'm just going to customize the color. So I'm going to click on it. I'm going to go to Shape Format and all the way along to Format Pane. Over here you'll find this menu. If we click on the bucket, go down to Fill. Now this is referring to the inside color. So we're going to use a gradient for this. If you don't want to, you can just go down to Color and pick a color of your choice. But I'm going to go down to Gradient. And here you can see this slider with these markers. Now you can add or take away these markers by using the plus or minus sign here. But we can change the color of these markers as well. Just click on it, go to color, and then you can click any color of your choice. If we go to red, you can see how that's changed my gradient. And if I move the slider, you can see the effect that that has. So for this demonstration, I've just picked the blue. Let me just move this over. So if you go down to color, and then I've just selected this dark blue here. And then on this one, I've just gone to the blue next to it and just selected linear. And in my direction, I think I selected this one here. Then all I'm going to do is turn round this triangle. And then I'm just going to move it up to the corner here. Now this shape also has a line around the outside. You may not be able to see it, but if we go down to line, it says we clicked on solid line. We want to get rid of that line, so I'm just going to click no line. And then I'm going to duplicate this triangle. Now you can do this a number of ways. You can do Command or Control C, Command or Control V, or you can go to the Home tab, go to Copy, deselect the shape, go to Paste. Or I find the easiest thing is just to select the shape, hold down my Alt or Option key and click and drag, and that will copy and paste your shape. So let's just delete one of these. Then again, we're going to turn this one round, and then we're going to move it down to the bottom here, but we are actually going to make it a lot bigger. So you see there, I haven't held my Shift key down, hold my Shift key again, and then let's just move that down. Then we're going to go back up to Insert, Shape, and this time we're going to select this shape here and then just click and drag out that shape, again holding down your Shift key. And then we're just going to rotate it. And then it is going to go along here. So what we're going to do is try and line these two lines up here so they're parallel. And then again, we're going to select the same gradient and take off the border. So again, select it, go back over to Format Shape, go to Line, select No Line, and then go to Fill, and again, Gradient Fill. And you should get the same gradient that you had previously. But to just add a little bit of interest, I'm just going to move the slider so we make this particular gradient just a little bit darker. And I'm just going to make this a little bit bigger, holding down my Shift key. And I'm going to move this to here. Now I'm going to copy and paste this or hold down my Option key. Make sure that you've selected the shape, then hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag out another one, click away, select only one, and again, drag out another one. We're going to line all these up, space them out correctly, but before we do that, we're just going to add a shadow. So we should have added this beforehand. So if you add this shadow to the first shape before you duplicate it, you won't have to do this several times. So I'm just going to go down to this shadow here. And I'm just going to repeat that shadow. And again, shadow, that's on the hexagonal option here onto effects. So I'm just going to line these up, select them all by holding down your Command or Control key. Go to Shape Format. Go to Align, click on the drop down and go to Distribute Vertically. Then that will mean they're all equally spaced out. That hasn't done that particularly well, so I'm just going to click away. I'm just going to move this one. Sometimes when you move them, they behave. So again, just click them all, holding down the Command or Control key, align. Yeah, that's done it this time. And then we're going to align to right. And that's just going to make sure they're all perfectly lined up to the right. And once we've done that, we're going to go to Group, select Group, and click Group. And we're just going to use my arrow key just to move them over to the left slightly. Perfect. Now we're going to grab one of these. I forgot to copy and paste it, so just ungroup. Click on this one. I'm just going to copy this one. I'm just going to select these all again, holding down my Command or Control key and clicking on each of them, and then just go to Group. Then I'm just going to move this one over to add a little bit more interest. You can make this as big or as small as you want. You can move it up, down, stretch it out. It's really up to you. And then to add some text or a logo, let's add the logo first up here. So I've already got a pre-selected logo, so go to Insert. And then we go to Pictures, Picture from File. I'm going to pre-select my logo here and then click Insert. Once it's selected, you find your logo, you can't move it. So select it, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text and select In Front of Text. And then you can move it and resize it and then place it anywhere you want. Now for some text, let's go to Insert, Text Box, Draw Text Box. Click and drag out a text box. Now, if we click away, we can see that it's got a black border. We want to get rid of that. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to this icon here, which is Outlines, and select No Outline. And then we're just going to pop our text in. And then for this text, we can customize this. Just if the cursor is inside, you can't customize the text unless you select it all. So if you just click away and click back on, so your cursor disappears, you can then go to Home and begin to customize that text. So select it. I'm going to select a different font. And then I'm going to use this increase font size tool here. And I'm just going to click that until I'm happy with the size. It will jump from 48, it'll go right up to 72, which is quite a big jump. So you can come down or you can select this element here. Let's say, let's put that to 50 and press enter. And just let's move that down a bit. Let's move that to about here. And then I'm going to copy and paste it again, holding down my Alt or Option key. And then I'm just going to type out some more text. It's going to reduce the size of that. And just generally try and line up the sides here. You can try and select them both, holding down your Command or Control key. Go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Left. Sometimes the margins don't quite work and it doesn't quite line up. If by eye you don't feel it does, then just select it and you can use your arrow keys to move left and right. Is another option. So I'm just going to put some more text up here. Again, select this box, hit the Alt or Option key to copy and paste it. And then I'm going to put in some text. I'm going to change the font, so this time I've just selected it all, and then go down to Brasilia. Just going to reduce the size of that wording. There we go. I'm going to copy and paste this one, and I'm just going to put some random text in here. Okay, so I'm just going to change this text back to Calibri, I think. There we go. Line that up, see how that looks. And then again, we can have some further text down here. I'm going to move that text over to the right here. So go up to the Home tab and select this icon here, and everything shifts over to the right or right alignment. We can put that text down there like that. And then you can go ahead and add as much text as you like, just copy and paste all the text boxes, and then you can go ahead and fully customize them all. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.